Section 2.4 is about the precise definition of the limit. The first thing to remember is just some the idea of distance on the number line. This expression means that the distance from x to 2 is less than 3. So if I was to graph this, I would start here at 2. And I'm looking for all values of x such that the distance from x to 2 is less than 3. So and that is essentially this set of numbers right here, not including negative 1 and 5. You can also solve this algebraically and get the same same graph. The next thing I want to do is introduce the notation delta and epsilon. And these are just Greek letters that are used to represent very small positive numbers. The next thing I'm going to do is take a look at this example here. And the question asks us to use the graph of f to find delta such that if the distance between x and 3 is smaller than delta, then the distance between f of x and 2 is less than 0.3. So here is the graph of the function f. It's just this curve that goes through the quadrant. So I'm going to look at this statement on the graph. It's saying that the distance between x and 3 is less than delta. So I'm going to look over on the x-axis. So here's 3. And you can see that these values are close to 3. But we haven't chosen delta yet. Okay, now let's look at this statement right here. F of x minus 2, so the distance between f of x and 2 is less than 0.3. So let's just find f of x. F of x is over here, and in this case, it's going to be on this axis. And here I have 2. So the f of x are just corresponding to the values along this axis. Okay. So now that I've located what I'm looking for, what I'm trying to do is I want to find delta, meaning a distance, such that as long as I'm within this distance of 3, my outputs are going to be within this distance of 2. So I'm going to first go over to this axis and take a look at what's happening over here. I can see over here that the distance, this is the set of values where the distance between f of x and 2 is less than 0.3, because you could see that this goes down from 1.7 to 2.3. So for all of the values inside of this interval, I can see that the inequality is satisfied. Now what I'm going to do is look over here to the graph and then down. And I can see that as long as my x values fall within this area, that the inequality will be satisfied. Okay, so the distance from 2.75 to 3 is 0.25. The distance between 3 and 3.5 is 0.5. So I'm going to let delta equal 0.25. So now, which is the smaller value, so now if the distance between x and 3 is less than 0.25, then, okay, and that would be the set of values in here. These are the values that are satisfy the inequality. Then it's definitely true that the distance between two in f of x, which is this set of values, falls within 0.3 units of 2. So the inequality is actually satisfied. Okay. Just as a side note, why didn't I choose 0.5? Why did I choose 0.25 and not 0.5? Well, if I had chosen 0.5, then the set of all x that are a distance 0.5 from 3 would be given by this green interval right here. And you can see that if I look up at my function and look at the values of f of x, they no longer fall within the desired distance from 2. Okay, I've got values all the way down here. So what I had to do was I chose the smaller of the two distances here to sort of squeeze in my outputs. The one last thing I want to do is to prove that in this example, we're going to use the precise definition of the limit to show that the limit as x approaches 1 of 2x plus 1 is equal to 3. So using the definition, we let epsilon greater than 0 be given. The goal is we must find delta greater than 0 such that if the distance between x and 1 is less than delta, then the distance between f of x and 3 is less than epsilon. The key to doing this is to look at this inequality and note that f of x minus 3 is less than epsilon if and only if 2x plus 1 minus 3 is less than epsilon, which simplifies to 2x minus 2 is less than epsilon. And finally, we can factor the 2 out, and we get x minus 1 is less than epsilon. So this is true whenever the distance between x and 1 is less than epsilon over 2. So essentially, this condition that the distance between f of x and 3 is less than epsilon is equivalent to the condition that the distance between x and 1 is less than epsilon over 2. So we're going to let delta be equal to epsilon over 2, because we can see that as long as this condition is satisfied, this condition is also satisfied. Since epsilon was chosen, you know, arbitrarily, this is true for any positive small number epsilon, and therefore we've actually proved using the precise definition, that's the delta epsilon definition, that the limit as x approaches 1 of this line is equal to 3.